The Creator is good, for He brings everything to us. He might bring us some hard times, but He gives us some good times. And all we have to do is just open ourselves to it. Embrace it.
What this world needs are the women's voices. The women's voices to really tune people into their soul, into their hearts.
Guide people to open their heart center so that they're able to get in touch with why they're here, their purpose, not why society thinks they should be here or their family, but their soul's destiny.
Grandmas are our treasure. A treasure buried deep.
In our country, a lot of the older, you know, the great grandmother types are have become invisible, and their wisdom that they've gained from their experience in life is just, it's dying with them.
It's important for all of us to have a voice, because for most of my life I did not.
Aging is a journey. It's a journey. It's a journey through life.
If we continue to keep our women from knowing their own personal power, we not only go down as a family, we go down as a nation, and then we go down as a planet.
The Women's Voices journey started with a dream. In the dream, I was walking through a path in the woods. I came to a stream where I saw a beautiful old Tlingit canoe. I realized that I couldn't get into the canoe with the pack on my back. So I took it off, climbed inside the canoe, and the next thing I knew, I was headed down the stream, just gently flowing, and I felt at one with everything around me and with the world.
What I realized was that while I was successful in many ways in the eyes of the world, I had a good job and a nice home, and I've been married for 32 years, and I have two wonderful children. Inside, I knew that there was still a piece of me, a part of me that was missing. And what the dream revealed to me was that I really wasn't living my life purpose. So I began to make some changes. I wrote to two friends that I had met when I traveled to the Sakha Republic in Russia and suggested that they might want to go with me on the journey of a lifetime. I thought, let's set out to go on this good red road. Let's ask grandmothers from the farthest north point where people live, down through Russia, through Alaska, and then north south across the United States about peace and about what they think is important.
Wide and wild, stretches common miles, cutting through the stones of history.
The women we interviewed were Yurok, Navajo, Tlingit, Irish, Aboriginal, Australian, Russian, English, Iranian, Armenian, South African, Chinese, Chumash, and more. They were Christians, Jews, Baha'is, Muslims, agnostics, and those who practiced their native ways. They lived in a San Francisco mansion, Siberian villages, a trailer in Yuma, state housing in Yakutsk, Alaskan towns, cities, and suburbs. They were rich, poor, abused, abandoned, honored, and forgotten, and they welcomed us in their lives. We approached all of them as strangers, and we left them as friends.
Paint the Rocky Mountain skies. One more circle around the world again. One more year rolls down the Rio Grande.
My friends thought it was crazy. Everyone I knew thought it was crazy. I even thought it was crazy. I remember being completely terrified, driving my car onto the ferry from Juneau, Alaska. I didn't even think I could get the car onto the ferry down the car ramp, and being completely terrified that what if this didn't work out? What was I doing? I left a great job. I was leaving a house. What was I doing? But the minute I got on that ferry, and the minute it started pulling out onto the open water out in down the channel out of Juneau, a sense of peace came over me. And I knew for the first time in many, many years that I really was on a journey that was about my own transformation, as well as hopefully the transformation of other people.